Hello and welcome back to a brand new Player Two Plays. My name is Paul James and today we are playing Lord of the Rings Gollum, the brand new game from Datalik and Nacon. And thanks to both of those parties, I am playing the game prior to release. At this point, we are still being kind of heavily tutorialized through chapter one. There's some weird checkpointing that's gone on because I've actually completed this bit, stopped at the end of a chapter, quit back to the main menu. Gollum's detective vision. Now we're currently being pursued by a ringwraith, which is none too ideal. So this is very much the tutorial section. Oh, here we go. We've hit a dead end. Let's just run at it. I know how this ends. There we go. I guess, like, some initial impressions, and look for a fully expanded upon review at the same time as this Player 2 plays going live. My first impressions, visually, rough. Gollum doesn't look crash hot. Gandalf, who we'll see momentarily, not looking too good either. The Ringwraiths, they've obviously got a pretty basic sort of design in a sense, and so there should be a trophy pinging, boom, right now for completing this. I've just recently completed this and now progress no further than this moment. This is Gandalf. Sorry, that's Gollum. The other guy is Gandalf, called Wizard, with the subtitles. So go figure on that one.
Look at me.
Doesn't sound like Gandalf.
They brought you to him, didn't they? The Dark Lord. What did you tell him? What did you tell Sauron?
Nask.
The ring.
Nask.
What did you tell him?
The Nazgul have him. There's also some pretty rough textures, environmental textures that I've come across so far. Others that... I'm honestly not sure if they... Did I just... We got a crash. Excuse me, we're going to have a quick cut as we return back to the action.
It hurts. Are they gone?
It's crashed again. Oh my god. All right, let's try this again. Hilariously, there was another crash along the way where I went to go pick up the mushroom that the Gollum eats there, that's kind of part of that tutorial moment there, and the game crashed a second time. So we're going really well. I hadn't encountered any crashes to that point, just some dodgy textures and some less than ideal voice acting and recreations of Gandalf. But I had not seen bugs. Now I got Windows notifications popping off. That's unfortunate. Let's hope nothing happens this time. Now, it is fascinating narratively through the lens that we get to see this Gollum perspective, and we know that the Rays now make their way to Hobbiton at this point. And so, I mean, the fact they didn't kill Sméagol Gollum at this point is incredible, but anyway, they didn't. He's out and about again. So Gandalf doesn't look good at all. Gollum looks a bit rough. There's some dodgy textures. The game crashes. Lots of technical and visual and audio problems. Gameplay-wise, it is a pretty basic stealth game. I will have full thoughts on the Player 2 website soon enough in the form of a review, and the game might get better as it goes, but the initial impressions, not great. It is a 10-chapter long game. You gonna let me take that then?
Shut up, Glashnag.
Please, Sméagol doesn't know a thing. We swears. Finn, old man, must tell them.
Be quiet. You will get us all killed.
What's this for?
It's your number 4.
Lay down.
Sleep for Gollum. Like, why couldn't we get Andy Serkis in? At least. But anyway, narratively, interesting to see how it intermingle. Oh no. I can't finish cutscenes without it crashing. One more cut, and we'll see what happens one more time. Alright, we are back trying it again. What has happened to the old frail man? This is... I've never done a player two plays like this. This is something. Take my slave tag.
Be quiet. You will get us all killed.
What's this for?
It's your number 4.
Lay down. Gonna talk again.
No, quiet. Yes, very quiet.
And so there's a degree of choice present in the game, and there's been, I wouldn't call it a key decision so far. There was like an insect that you could kind of react to it and aggressively like Gollum, or more with a peaceful heart like Sméagol. And I've noticed looking at the trophy list of the game that there does seem to be something connected to potentially consistent behaviour, or maybe 100% consistent behaviour, as, you know, demonstrating more Sméagol peaceful behaviours as opposed to aggressive ones. Like what we might see from Gollum. But in terms of, you know, I mean, like that one and this thing with the insect have been all there is so far. But I'm interested to know if it is going to culminate in something. Maybe another crash. Like, yeah, I'll be curious to know if it culminates in something of any substance. This is the second chapter of 10 in the game. And I've now suffered 3 crashes in about 45 minutes of gameplay.
Get back.
Not
Get back.
Ideal.
Sméagol doesn't know what to do.
Reading.
Move, you scum.
The great eye sees us.
The beast master over here. I feel like every time I go to a cutscene, the game's going to break at this point. This won't be a super long player two plays between all the cuts and my hesitance to continue to show it in a broken state. But in the reviewing scene, we play it exactly as it lies. The game is not overly functional right now.
The masters tell you.
Run till your feet are bloody.
What is that thing? Not a dwarf. Not a goblin. Too ugly for either.
Be quiet.
Nailed it.
My king.
The Morrocks like them.
Let me see.
I'm not picking up scattered
bones. Like textures. Textures are either horrific or just not loading at points. Even these bloody ones, pretty basic as well. It is a shame that one of the most acclaimed licenses of all time, J.R.R. Tolkien's The Lord of the Rings is being dragged a bit here.
Please, we don't understand.
This way.
But it could culminate something good, so please
Smeagol.
Check my review on the Player 2 website.
You're going to die down here.
Check my review on the Player 2 website for more expanded thoughts where I can render a verdict and tell you whether you want to stick with this one or not.
The
beasts, if they run at you, find cover. Get to high ground if you can. They don't have the best eyes. Open the pens and lure them in there. Then quickly close the gates.
Hands.
All right. I will help you. Climb the ladder. The gate is not for us. First things first. Slaves chase the gate.
It's happened again. Unbelievable. That is an unceremonious end to this entry of Player 2 Plays. You are getting a sense for the state of the Lord of the Rings Golem at this particular point in time. I insist that you check out my review on the Player 2 website, that is player2.net.au, because things may be very, very different upon launch, upon completion of the game, upon patches launching in what is a, if I'm being transparent, a 5 to 6 day window prior to launch. I'm worried. I'm real worried. Huh. Well, if you're intrigued by this entry of Player 2 Plays and you want to see more with games that are functional, then please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing. All the buttons down below. Hit the notification bell. That way you're alerted to every new video. The moment it goes live on the channel. That includes Patch, Player 2 Plays, Gamer School, and a whole bunch more. There's some awesome stuff there, so please subscribe and go and check it out. This one is... it's a thing. Visit the website, player2.net.au, for reviews, including the one for the Lord of the Rings Golem. Reviews, previews, opinion pieces, news, features, links to the podcast series, Patch, the Player 2 Pixelcast, and Dev Diary. There's been some sensational guests on the show in recent weeks and months, and there are more to come, so please subscribe and go and check it out. We're on Patreon, patreon.com/player2au. Kicking a few bucks. The lower tiers, early access to episodes. At the higher tiers, monthly episode exclusives. And finally, there's Twitter. You'll find me at Paul James Games. The website, you'll find a player2au. And until next time, that was, I don't know, you probably saw like 2 minutes of Lord of the Rings Golem gameplay amongst cutscenes and crashes. It was a time. But we were all glad to experience it together. Think. Anyway, we'll wrap things up there. If you please, I hope you enjoyed something about this Player 2 Plays, because I didn't. Thanks a lot for watching. Cheers.